Hi everybody. So we're going on a trip and we're gonna be gone for like a month and a half. I just came home from Oregon last week and haven't even really unpacked, and now I'm trying to pack to leave to like 5 countries. So I'll see you tomorrow, because tomorrow is go time. Our flight leaves at like 12:30 a.m. and then we get into El Salvador at 11 something a.m. So this is gonna be quite fun. Okay, stay tuned.
At DIA for a while now, and it's pretty sick. You got these United terminals, and they have this really cool display here. Check it out. We're gonna walk by even though there's no one here. So like, whoa, it's like instead of one giant belt, it's like, you know, alien columns. Have you ever seen the Pokemon movie where they make the Pokemon clones? It's kind of like that. Up here, it's brand new white marble floors. Oh, check out this mountain. I think it's actually a fake mountain, because I've done most of 14ers myself and I've never seen that in Colorado, but it's beautiful nonetheless. So look, show everyone.
Epic.
Pretty cool, a little bit odd, but I like it. Now we reach the end of the rope, just sneak under.
Oh, we gotta go under again?
Now we gotta go find our brother. So brother actually.
I'm so sorry. Can you get there, dude?
Do you know what you call those things?
Movie theater.
Movie theater waiting strap buckle. I actually call it a stanchion.
A stanchion.
I actually got a sore eye right now.
Ah! Wait, let's see it. Bitch, you can't really see you.
So let's talk conspiracy.
Ready?
What do you know?
So I know that the Denver airport has a lot of conspiracies around it. Like, it's a bunker. There's like a bunker under the airport that they built for like when they put in the One World Order. Is that what you've heard? Yeah? Yeah. What have you heard? And the murals?
Well, basically, it's not right. There's a barbed wire fence.
Dude, what gates are we?
It's we're getting off here. There's a barbed wire fence to keep people in instead of keeping people out.
Oh.
So the barbed wire fence is slanted inward. So basically, it's like a jail fence. It keeps people in.
Right, because why else? Why else would? Alright guys, we landed and now we're going to, what's it called?
Corona Beach House.
Corona Beach House, to use Logan's, what is it, like a free?
The priority pass travel card.
Logan,
I'll just say it straight up.
Logan has a priority pass travel card and,
arrived.
Oh shoot, dude. It's like barely open.
It's open though. We have 3 complimentary drinks at the San Salvador Airport.
Right. Well, also, I want coffee.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, so what's happening right now is we're sitting at this restaurant, and we just ordered quite a bit of food that's quite expensive because Logan's priority pass will cover
right.
It. Because it covers, so he's a priority pass member holder person, and it gives him $30, and a person he's with, it gives them $30 to spend. So we're spending it for sure.
We got a $22 steak and eggs, $12 croissant breakfast sandwich, and $12 breakfast quesadilla. And yeah, that should all come under $60 we have to spend.
Exactly. So
pretty stoked. Trying to soak up the value of this card. I'm not sponsored, not being paid to say this, but if you guys travel a lot, I highly recommend getting a travel card. You can get lounge access, free restaurant eats, and buffets. The best use of it, I would say, is kind of overseas in Africa, Asia, South America. The lounges are really nice because there's less card holders, so the benefits kind of go farther. But in the US and the West and Europe, it's still pretty good.
but because there's so many card holders of these passes and travel cards, the benefits, like the lounges get packed and they don't offer, you know, buffets and stuff like that as often. But this is a pretty sweet deal. So the West, it's not too shabby either. Taking advantage of it today.
Stanley Cup is on tonight.
Yep.
Stanley Cup is on tonight. Avalanche is playing. Y'all better be there. We're gonna be there. Well, we're not gonna be there, but we're gonna watch it, so.
Amazing today. Thank you, Lord, for this food. It's really filling my good mood. We pray every blessing on the plate that it would be a really good date. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Show a happy face.
Yo, dude. These shots are like so quality.
All right, so we just came in. I would say to
happy people. We'll let you know how it is.
I'm not even like embarrassed to vlog here because I just feel like it's Miami. Like so much odd stuff happening. It's like vlogging is the least of people's worries. I don't give a crap.
Dang, that's pretty good.
We made it.
Do you have a seatbelt? I don't think mine works.
Oh wait, I think I might, yeah.
Oh, sí.
Vamos. I don't think it works. Like Ross. Okay, everyone, welcome to San Salvador, El Salvador. Right now we're going to the mall. We're gonna get SIM cards or just a single SIM card. And then we're gonna check it out and see if maybe we can get some snacks or like milkshakes or something like that. But yeah, let's go.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned, everybody.
There's a guard for Starbucks.
Gotta protect the beans.
Check it out.
This is like so bougie. I love how like no one would probably really think that malls in El Salvador are like better than our malls. But to me this looks nicer.
Better than Colorado El Salvador.
Oh yeah, Chapel Hills could never.
Look at Chuck.
Yay!
Go.
Man who broke the bank at Monte Carlo.
The man who broke the bank at Monte Carlo.
Monte Carlo. Guys, we're in my favorite store right now. Miniso. They just have the best freaking stuff in here. They literally have like everything you can need and they have a lot of like random stuff, but they also have like Squishmallow, like plush stuffed animals and stuff, and they just have amazing stuff. And I'm sad because I don't really have room in my bag to buy anything, so like look at this,
so cute.
I love how they're literally the same exact face but they're different animals.
Wait, they are?
Yeah, it's Tom and Jerry, dude.
No, that's the same. Oh wait, what the heck? But that's a mouse too. That's supposed to be a cat.
Yep.
It's not like a cat to me. Dude, look how nice this stuff is. Backpacks and like the suitcases. Like they actually have nice stuff, you know? Like, don't play.
Soccer team. Garbage bag just...
What should we say, vamanos? Alright, we got some pupusas. We got different flavors. This is the El Salvadorian famous dish right here. Some got shrimp, like cheese, some got chicken and cheese, some got mushroom and cheese. This is called the loca. It's the crazy one. So it's like the big combo. We just saw them firing up over there. They got another one burning up. Yeah, it's a local kind of wall-to-wall shack. Good place. I'd recommend it, even though I haven't taken a bite yet. We'll let you know how it tastes, but this is definitely one of the famous local foods, so be sure to try it if you come here.
So it's raining really hard. So guys, to end the day, I just wanted to say it was a really good first day, and I have my retainer in, so I sound like an idiot, but it was a really good first day, and we really, really like El Salvador so far. It's not what I expected it to be. It's a lot better, I think, than I expected it to be, and I feel like it kind of gets a bad rap, but like, I feel like it deserves better. So hopefully I can like show it off kind of through this video. But yeah, right now Logan and I are just watching the Avalanche game, Stanley Cup Finals. It's the first game and they're about to go into overtime, which kind of sucks, but we are starting overtime with a power play. So hopefully we can score a goal and finish it out and I can go to bed because I'm really tired and haven't slept really, except for maybe like 2 hours total. Okay, well, that wraps up day one.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go. Welcome to the jungle. I'm so happy. I gotta call Dad.